When working with large amounts of data in a data grid, software developers are quickly encountering the need for providing filter operations to the users via the data grid. And that's what we are going to cover in this new video on the FNC data grid. The FNC data grid can be typically used in two scenarios, either data bound to a data set or have the data loaded directly into the grid itself. In the first scenario, when it is bound to a data set, when you perform filtering from the grid will actually pass on the filtering to the data set. So the data set will be filtered and the grid will visualize the data from the filtered data set. In the scenario where you have the data loaded into the grid, it is the grid that will perform the filtering operation itself on the data in the grid. Of course, you can perform the filtering via user interface, a user interface for filtering that is built in into the FNC data grid, and that we are going to cover in this video, but you can also do that in code. And we'll cover that code in a moment. And in addition, there are also a couple of filter events that we will also show you in this video. Filter events that give you extra control, extra capabilities on the filtering in the grid. But first of all, I wanted to draw your attention to how you can programmatically add filters in the grid with the grid.filter collection, which is a collection of filter conditions. You fill one or multiple conditions into this collection, and as you can see here, this is done via a unique chained filter code construct. You can see here that we are adding three conditions with the add operator and then the logical and operator for adding the second condition to the filter, and then also a third condition via the logical or operator. When the conditions with these logical operators have been added to the filter collection, the filter is activated by calling the datagrid.applyFilter method. But let's have a look at the demo that we prepared for you for this video directly from the IDE and go through, walk through the filtering capabilities in the FNC data grid. And this is the demo in the Delphi IDE. We have a FireMonkey application with the FNC data grid, but as you know, the FNC data grid can also be used in a VCL Windows application. It can even be used in a web client application created with TMS Web Core. But for this demo, we are going to stick to a FireMonkey application. We have the grid on the form and we have some code that will initialize the data. Here in this demo, we are not going to use a data bound grid. We are going to load some sample data into this grid, which is done with the grid.load sample data call. And the grid will have 7 columns and will have 300 rows filled with this random data. We are going to enable the filter user interface built in into this data grid by setting grid.options.filtering.enable to true. The user interface for the filtering will be defined in the first row or the row with index 1. And we are going to enable both the filter drop-down button and the filter editor as filter UI. You can also choose either one of these, but in this demo, we are going to use both. So let's maybe first have a look when I run this demo, how it looks like. And here it is, our demo. And as you can see on the row with index 1, we have our filter user interface and we have the filter edit here, the filter dropdown for each column. If we check off the filter dropdown, you see that the dropdown button will disappear. Also notice that we have a spin editor here, a regular edit here, a date picker in this column, because this column contains dates. Here we have a text column again, so we have a regular editor, and here we have columns filled with numbers, so automatically a spin editor is chosen to edit our filter conditions. If I enter some data here, like Terzi, for example, you can see that only the rows containing somewhere Terzi are shown in the grid. All the other rows are filtered. We also have the filter clear button here. And we have also, if I type the letter M, and here I say that it does not contain an M, we can see that this particular filter condition is applied. When I clear the filter again, click the drop down. The drop down is automatically filled with the unique values found in that column. Here we perform programmatic filtering. So when I click these buttons, the filter is programmatically initiated, and I can also clear this filter. To see this in code, what is happening is our unique chained construct to create, in this case, two filter conditions with the logical AND operator, and it is applied to the column with the column header name and the one with status, which is our second column for the filter condition. And the other programmatic added filter is a filter with three conditions, also built here with this logical AND operator. And when the filter condition is set, then apply filter is called. To undo this filtering, we can simply call grid.removeFilter. Now let's come back to multi-column filtering. So when I perform here in this column, for example, a filtering and say larger than 50, we see here all values larger than 50. Notice also that here in the caption, and I'll come to that in a moment, we see that there are 155 rows with a value larger than 50. If I now change for this column the condition to smaller than 50, we see now that the filter is applied. For this column, we have 158 rows with a value smaller than 50. But as you can see in this column, we have again values lower than 50, so we clearly do not have a multi-column filter from the user interface. It is the last filter that is applied that we see. If we enable multi-column and change this, for example, again to larger than 50, now we can see that the filter is applied to both columns, 4 and 5 in this case, where here it contains the values larger than 50, here it contains the values lower than 50, so only rows that match these two conditions are filtered. And finally, I also wanted to cover custom filter values. When I have a look at, and maybe let's first undo this filter again, like this, and now I click the drop down on the last column, we can see that it does not contain the unique values for this column, but predefined values. I show you in a moment how I have achieved this. And when I, for example, now apply this filter, you can see that it will filter all the rows based on the values in this dropdown. So now I only leave the rows that have here values 30, 80, and 90. And like this, I can perform the filtering. How did we do that? There is an event for that, which we can use to override the values in the dropdown. And that event is onNeedFilterDropdownData. When I go and have a look at the code in this event handler, you can see that for column number 6, I'm clearing all the predefined values, which would be the unique values for that column. And instead of these unique values, I'm filling this dropdown with a series of the multiples of 10 from 1 to 9, and which is the values that you can see in this filter dropdown. Finally, I also wanted to draw your attention to another filter-related event, which is the event on after apply filter. And this is an event that is called after the filter operation is performed from a change in the filter user interface, then this filter is called, and you can read from here the number of filtered rows. And for example, in like we do in this demo, we are going to update the form caption to this number of rows that was filtered, and also the last filter conditions, which is communicated or passed through via this event handler. So this gave you an introduction, an overview of the filtering capabilities in the FNC data grid. Here in a non-data bound scenario, when you bind your grid to a data set, you can do the same with the user interface and also programmatically. The only difference is that the filter will then be applied to your data set, and the grid will filter, of course, will show, of course, all the data that is in your filtered data set. We hope that made you clear how powerful the filtering capabilities are in the FNC data grid. We have more to cover on our powerful data grid in this video series. So that's why it is interesting to subscribe to this video here on the subscribe button below, and you will be automatically informed when we have a next video on our FNC data grid.